Silver is a shimmering precious metal, often used in jewelry making and the production of components in a naturally existing metal. Yet the process to extract silver from the earth requires a combination of geology, mining, engineering, and chemistry. From the depths of silver mines to the extraction of silver from ores, today's video will embark you on a journey like never before. If you have ever wondered how silver is made, grab your snacks as we step into the world of silver mining and processing. For centuries, humanity has used silver in various forms. From currency to electricity conduction and even making jewelry, silver has time and again proven its value. The earliest use of silver can be dated back to 4000 BCE, where silver coins were used as a currency and largely used for production of ornaments and jewelry. However, the process of mining silver and refining it to come out as a solid, shiny piece of metal is an exhausting task. Mining of silver ores. Silver is not an abundant metal. In fact, around 80% of the silver is extracted as a byproduct of either mining for other metals or through recycling of different metal-containing components. The silver-bearing ores are usually mined by using either an open-pit mining technique or the underground mining process. This entirely depends on how deep the ore is buried. The ores are mined using unique machinery, which digs deep into the earth, making a pathway for the miners to access the ore and extract it using trucks and cranes. The silver deposits are usually found in long cylindrical shapes and are made up of various solid substances. Because of their cylindrical shape, the silver deposits are often called veins. Silver does not exist alone. It is mostly found as a secondary element attached to zinc, lead, or copper ores. Therefore, almost 50% of the silver found globally is extracted while mining for other metals. For this reason, silver is often referred to as a byproduct of zinc, lead, and copper mining. Although silver mines are abundantly found in the globe of different continents, some of the oldest mining operations were carried out in Peru and Norway. The mines are still active today, and silver is still extracted from these areas. The next step is to transport the extracted ores from the mining pits to the factories, where the ores undergo a rigorous refining process. The ores are first put into large grinders, and a soft powder is made by crushing the ores. This powder is what will go under a separation procedure known as flotation. Once the powder is made, it is deposited into large wells containing water and different chemicals. The chemically induced water comes into contact with the ore powder, and a chemical reaction begins, separating the different metals and minerals from the powder. Given that virtually all ores consist of sulfides, they are suitable for undergoing flotation separation. However, different ores have different concentrations of metals such as lead, copper, and zinc. The separation process slightly differs depending on what metal is found in the majority of the ore. Generally, there are three different types of concentrates. Copper concentrates. The copper concentrates undergo flotation and electro-refining. Once electro-refining is completed in the wells containing a special electrolyte liquid, impurities settle on the surface in the form of mud. This mud usually contains silver. This mud is collected from the surface of the refining tank and smelted in a high-temperature furnace, and air is supplied to the furnace at high pressure. The air acts as a catalyst for oxidization, and since silver cannot be oxidized, it becomes easier to separate the silver from the remaining oxidized metals. The molten metal still contains different metals such as gold and platinum. To separate the silver, the molten metal is poured into molds and casted as anodes, which later undergo electro-refining. The electro-refining process separates the silver, and through this, even 99.99% pure silver can be obtained. Lead concentrates. The segregation of silver from ores containing the majority quantity of lead is slightly different. The lead concentrates are first roasted and then smelted to remove several impurities such as tin, arsenic, and silver. Then comes the Parks process, where zinc is added to the molten lead bullion. The zinc rapidly comes into contact with gold and silver, and formulates insoluble compounds with these metals. Afterwards, the zinc is removed and recovered by using a method called vacuum retorting, and the silver and gold are skimmed off. Zinc concentrates. Similar to lead concentrates, the ores with high zinc quantities are also roasted. However, they are then treated with sulfuric acid, which helps in dissolving the zinc. This procedure is known as leaching. Once the zinc content is fully dissolved, a residue containing silver, gold, and lead remains on the surface of the refining well. Here, the residue is transferred into a furnace, and the slag fuming process begins. Slag fuming converts the lead into a metallic form and is separated, whereas the silver and gold remains. The lead bullion is then subjected to lead refining, where the silver is separated and extracted. Silver alloys. Silver itself in the pure state is a relatively soft metal, and can crystallize even at room temperature, regardless of being hardened by forging or rolling. Hence, silver in its pure form is not suitable to be used for manufacturing jewelry, electronics, or other items. To make silver usable, it is imperative to create an alloy. You might have heard of jewelry being made of sterling silver. Sterling silver is actually an alloy. Copper is mixed with the pure silver to give the precious metal a solid form fit for being mended and shaped. Usually, sterling silver contains around 92.5% silver content, bonded with 7.5% copper. Similarly, alloys used to make coins contains 90% silver and 10% copper. The alloys are stable in the air. However, they do tend to tarnish in the presence of sulfur. To prevent the tarnishing of silver alloys, palladium is added to it. Prevention of tarnish is especially important where the alloy is to be used in circuit breakers, telephone relays, or several other electrical components. Polishing and corrosion resistance of silver alloys. Silver alloys are not inherently shiny. They require lustering. The most common method employed to give silver its shiny presence are cyanide-based baths. Silver alloys are dipped into these chemical baths and then cleaned, giving them a magnificent mirror-like shine. Another added benefit of cyanide baths is the corrosion resistance. The coating of cyanide leaves the alloy corrosion-free, suitable to be used for different purposes. Common uses of silver. The unique properties of silver allow it to be used in new technology and industrial production. Often used in solar panels, silver acts as a conductor on the photovoltaic cells of solar panels, enabling the cells to capture light and convert it into usable electricity. Silver is also largely used as catalysts to speed up different chemical reactions. One example is the production of plastic. To induce a sped-up reaction, silver is used to produce ethylene oxide, which is a primary chemical for making plastic. Apart from its industrial uses, silver also has great uses in the medical field. Dental surgeries are often done using silver, since the metal possesses antimicrobial properties, resulting in slightly reduced risks of infections. Largest silver-producing countries globally. In 2019, China achieved the title for producing the highest quantity of silver, of around 4,300 metric tons. Till date, China holds the title of the largest silver-producing country on Earth. Mexico also significantly contributes to the production of silver. Producing over 3,700 metric tons of silver in 2019, it is also one of the largest countries in the business of mining and producing silver. As we mentioned before, one of the oldest mines of silver is in Peru. It happens to also be one of the largest silver-producing countries in the world. In 2019, around 2,900 metric tons of silver production was reported out of Peru. What did you think of today's video, elucidating the intricacies of silver mining and production? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed today's video, then make sure to leave us a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to always be updated with the most exciting content as soon as it's uploaded. Thanks for watching. See you again soon in another video.